จริงจริงSo at the end of this revision for chapter 1, you should be able to define what is excess reactant, what is a limiting reactant, what is conversion, and then you should be able to identify limiting reactant and calculate conversion. So let's start with this basic terminology. So we have this reaction. 4 iron react with 3 oxygen to form 2 iron oxide. So this equation is shown stoichiometrically. So that means 4 iron will react with 3 oxygen to form 2 iron oxide. Okay? So that means the stoichiometric coefficient of iron is 4. Stoichiometric coefficient of iron is 4. Stoichiometric coefficient of oxygen is 3. And stoichiometric coefficient of iron oxide is 2. So let's consider the same reaction. If there are 2 moles of iron and 5 moles of oxygen in the reacting vessel, so that means initial there are 2 moles of iron and 5 moles of oxygen. So that means during the reaction, if 2 moles of iron reacted, that means at the end, finally, there's no more iron left. So if 2 moles of iron reacted, how many oxygen will react? It will be 3 divided by 4. Okay, 4 comes from the iron oxide here, times 2. So it will be 1.5 mole. So this can happen, right? So that means at the end of the reaction, there will be 5 minus 1.5, there will be 3.5 mole of oxygen left. So what does this mean? This means that oxygen is added in excess, while the iron is the limiting. If we try to check whether if initially there are 2 moles of iron and 5 moles of oxygen. If during the reaction, all the iron reacted, so that means 5 moles of iron reacted. How many 5 moles of oxygen reacted? So how many moles of iron is needed? So that means we will need 4. 4 is from the stoichiometric coefficient of iron divided by 3. 3 is from the stoichiometric coefficient of oxygen times the 5 moles of oxygen that reacted. So that means we'll need 20 divided by 3. We will need 6.6 mole. Is this possible? Cannot be possible because there's only 2 moles of iron initially. But what is needed is 6.6. So oxygen is not the limiting reactant. So what is the definition of excess reactant? So excess reactant is present in excess. Okay. While limiting reactant can fully react. Okay, present in limited amount and can 100% react. Now, conversion. Okay, if there's no species that follows the word conversion, that means the conversion is the conversion of the limiting reactant. Okay, so let's say the limiting reactant is A. So how do we determine the conversion of A? Is by using moles of A reacted divided by initial moles of A. I want to highlight the word moles. We have to use moles all the time. Never use concentration. Okay, moles, not concentration. If the reaction happened in a batch reactor, so how do we determine the conversion? It's moles of A reacted divided by initial moles of A. Moles of A reacted is initial moles of A minus final number of A divided by initial moles of A. Well, in a continuous process, because we have mass entering the reactor, and then we have mass coming out from the reactor, we need to use time basis. So in this case, for continuous process, is the number of moles of A reacted per unit time divided by initial number moles of A entering per unit time. So let's say we have FA in as the mole flow of A entering, and then we have the FA out as the mole flow of A out from the reactor. So how do we calculate the XA? Is by FA in minus FA out divided by FA in. Special cases, when we have constant volume, okay, so that means V1 equals to V2. And then we know mass is always constant, M1 equals to M2. Hence, when we have M1 divided by V1 equals to M2 divided by V2, that means it's a constant density. Often we can use concentration. Okay, this is a special case for constant density that could happen in a liquid phase reaction. Now let's look at this exercise 1.2-1. Initially there's 5 moles of hydrogen. So if we write the reaction, we have hydrogen plus bromine gas to produce 2 hydrogen bromide. So initially there's 5 moles of hydrogen and 3 moles of bromine and 0 moles of hydrogen bromide. So let's determine the limiting reactant. So during the reaction, if all the bromine reacted, so that means 3 moles of bromine reacted, so at the end there will be no bromine. There will be no bromine left. It requires 3 moles of hydrogen. So that means there will be 2 moles of hydrogen left. Is this possible? It's possible, right? So that means bromine is the limiting reactant. Okay, now if 2 moles of the limiting reactant, we have identified that the limiting reactant is bromine. So that means if 2 moles of bromine reacted, so here we have 2 moles of bromine reacted. So how many hydrogen will react. It's the same, right? Because the stoichiometric coefficient is 1:1. Every time 1 mole of bromine reacted, there will be 1 mole of hydrogen reacted. So how much hydrogen will be left? Be 5 minus 2, 3 moles. How many bromine will be left? Will be 3 minus 2, so 1. And then how many hydrogen bromide will form? It will be 2 times 2. Why the 2 here? The 2 comes from the stoichiometric coefficient. So it's equal to 4. So that means there will be 4 moles of hydrogen bromide gas. So the conversion of the limiting reactant is the amount of bromine reacted. So we have 2. So 2 bromine reacted divided by, initially we have 3 moles of bromine. So 2 divided by 3, 0.667. Moles of hydrogen gas remaining in the system is 5 minus 2, so it will be 3. So 3 moles. And the moles of hydrogen bromide gas formed will be 4 moles. Okay, we have discussed all this working. Now let's look at another exercise. Now in this exercise, we have nitrogen gas and we have hydrogen gas. Nitrogen and hydrogen will enter the reactor. The amount of hydrogen entering is 10 gram and the amount of hydrogen entering is 10 gram. So let's identify the limiting reactant. Now in this case, the mass is used, so we have to convert to mole. Okay, before that, let's the first step, we have to write the chemical equation between nitrogen and hydrogen. So in this case, 1 mole of nitrogen will react with 3 moles of hydrogen to form 2 ammonia. Okay, so nitrogen plus 3 hydrogen to form 2 ammonia. Okay, the moles of nitrogen, we have 10 gram, so that means 10 gram divided by the molecular weight of nitrogen is 28, so the result is 0.3571. and then the hydrogen in the feed is also 10 gram divided molecular atomic weight of hydrogen is 2, so we get 5 gram mole. So that means initially we have 0.3571 mole of nitrogen and 5 mole of hydrogen and 0 mole of ammonia. So now during the reaction, if we want to check which one is the limiting reactant, let's say all the nitrogen reacted. So all the nitrogen is 0.3571. If 0.3571 of nitrogen reacted, how many hydrogen will react? Will require 3 divided by 1. Where does this 3 come from? The 3 comes from the stoichiometric coefficient of hydrogen, and this one comes from the stoichiometric coefficient of nitrogen. Okay, the 3 is from the stoichiometric coefficient of hydrogen, the 1 is from the nitrogen, times 0.3571. So 3 times 0.3571 is 1.0713 mole. Okay, so is this possible? Yes, it's possible. So that means hydrogen is in excess and nitrogen is the limiting. Okay. Now, the maximum number of grams of ammonia that can be produced, that means the entire limiting reactant, in this case nitrogen, will be reacted. So how many ammonia will be formed? So how many ammonia will be formed will be 2 times. Why 2? This 2 comes from the stoichiometric coefficient of ammonia. 2 times 0.3571. So 2 times 0.3571 is 0.7142 mole. Then we convert this into mass by using the atomic weight. Okay, the next question is the percent excess of the excess reactant. So what is this percent excess of excess reactant? Okay, percent excess of excess reactant. So excess reactant in this question, in this exercise, is hydrogen. So the percent excess of hydrogen. So that means if all the 0.3571 mole of nitrogen is converted, it will require 1.0713 mole of hydrogen. So the percent excess is the excess of hydrogen. So initially there's 5 mole of hydrogen, and then what is reacted is 1.07, and then this is what reacted times 100%. So the result is 366.7%. Okay, so that's the end of our revision for